How do we figure out what to offer to the market? How do we understand how we can earn a living doing what we love? Well, let me share with you a simple diagram to help you discover that for yourself. So first of all, there are these two circles, and the circle on the left-hand side is where you can write down all of the topics that you love to teach, that you love to talk about, that you love to help clients with or help other people with. In other words, the topics of your passion. So write that down in the circle. All right, and the next step is to write down in this circle, what are the topics that the people you want to help, what do they buy? What kinds of coaching do they buy? What workshops do they attend? What books do they love to read? What programs do they love to enter themselves into? Okay, and guess what? It takes compassion to discover that. So passion alone is not enough to create a true livelihood. It also takes combining it with your compassion to be able to have the energy to study what others spend money on. Because remember, if you want to earn an income, where does that income come from? The income comes from other people spending money on you. So you need to have the compassion to study what they spend money on, okay? And you need to then combine your passion and your compassion so that you can say what you love doing in a way that they can understand. Because just on the left-hand side is your passion and enthusiasm. Your passion and enthusiasm may sell some people on spending money with you, but really it takes you moving into your heart of compassion to be willing to be energized by what others are energized by so that you can talk about things in a way that they buy, that they understand and they buy, okay? So one of the common questions then is, well, how do I find out what people spend money on, right? The first tool to use is Google. You can go to google.com and search how much money is being spent on and then put in your type of service. And you're trying to look for articles that talk about, okay, something is a $5 billion industry or something, you know, look for kind of dollar amounts for how much money is being spent on your industry, okay? Try to find that out. And also try to find out how many customers are in your industry. So if you can find out, for example, that there are a million people in your industry, that they're spending money in your industry every year, and $5 billion are being spent per year on your industry. Well, if you divide $5 billion by a million people, well, that's $5,000 per year per customer, per client that are being spent. So that's just a rough example, okay? Another way you could discover, do this kind of research is by paying someone to do it. So go to Fiverr.com, Fiverr.com, okay, and search market research on Fiverr.com and hire someone to do market research for you. For some of them are willing to do it for $5 an hour, and they are, of course, they don't live in the United States, probably live in a country where $5 an hour means a lot to them. And you can always give them bonuses, more money if they do a good job for you. Some of them, you can hire someone in the United States to do it for maybe $25 an hour, okay? And they could do that kind of market research for you. The second way is to ask people. Ask your friends and your family and your colleagues who are the type of client that you would like to serve, and ask them if they'd be willing to talk with you for 15 minutes. A private confidential conversation, and ask and be sure to let them know that it's important to you to know this information, and that it's a confidential information, and ask them, hey, you know, you're trying to figure out what people like them are spending money in terms of your type of service, and just say, hey, how much money do you spend on my type of service? Maybe it's nothing, maybe it's some, it's some money, but also ask if they know of people who spend money on your type of service. Okay, or a related service, and then see if they'd be willing to introduce you to that person so you can ask some confidential questions. And the other way is to ask other people in your field. If you have colleagues, find out, hey, how much are people tending to be spending on this type of service? Okay. Other internet tools that can be helpful is Quora.com, Quora.com. Go there and ask the question, hey, how much are people spending on average on this type of service? Okay. Or where are people spending in this area of expertise? What type of service are they buying? Another service is Reddit.com, Reddit.com. When you go to Reddit, there are sub forums called subreddits. If you go to Reddit, you can find out what they are. And subreddits are on specific topics. And you can go there and ask people who are interested in that topic what kinds of services and products are they spending money on. Okay? A final tool I'll share with you is Mint.com. Mint.com is what I use to track my money expenses and to do budgeting, and so do millions of people. And Mint.com is really just a service for Americans, US people. But the cool thing is if you go use Mint.com, it's free. You put in a category of spending, and Mint.com will show you a chart for how much people usually spend per month in the US on that particular category. So I hope this helps you to figure out, remembering that to be able to earn a livelihood doing what you love, it's not enough just to have a passion. It's also, you also must have enough compassion to find out what others are energized by, enough to spend money on, and then the intersection of that is your ideal niche. I look forward to any comments you have on what has been helpful for you to figure out what your niche is, and any questions you might have, feel free to put that below the video.